our finals, and one of the participants is Randy Stolklos. And it's time now to include Randy in our AVP file, Strange Stories, brought to you by Irish Spring Sport.
Well, after playing 21 years, I've seen a lot of crazy things happen. We were at a time that there weren't a lot of rules set out for us when we were younger. Things have changed now, a little bit more professional. But I think the strangest thing for me is a tournament that I played with St. John Smith against Karch Karai and Brent Verhoff, that Karch ended up ripping down the net. And very uncharacteristically for Karch, for something that, like that to happen. But it also happened at the very ending moments of the tournament. So that was probably the strangest thing that ever happened to me.
That was more like Hovland-like behavior, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah, but he had a reason for it, because Verhoff had hit the ball off Randy, and the referee didn't call the touch, which was obvious, so Karch reacted a little violently.
Well, he pulled on the net and just about
a little bit
tore it apart. I remember Ed Winchester, who's no longer refereeing on the tour, just went toppling down. It was, I agree with Randy, one of the strangest moments, and we bring it back to you on the AVP files. Our final is coming. The number one seeds, Kent Steffes and Jose Loiola, against the number three seeds, Brian Lewis and Randy Stolklos. The players getting ready.
I took a picture of Saturday. Not a special Saturday, just a regular.
In their 10th out of 13 tournaments. So Paul and Hov, back to you guys.
Well, that's been sort of the preview and the prognostication all season long since the King of the Beach, Karch Karai, gets injured. And right now, the two top players, both in their prime, are together, Jose Loiola and Kent Steffes. But what do Stolklos and Lewis do? They look good in the semifinals.
They look good. Play with confidence. Come out here and bombs away. Randy should be up there blocking every ball, too. I want him up there. That's their strength. You have to use your strength. Obviously, he's a better blocker. And Brian Lewis is going to get out back there and bomb. They've won before. They won in Chicago. They've been in a few other finals, so they've been here. They know the road.
Well, here is, in fact, their list of finishes back in 1993. Not good enough in Randy Stolklos's mind to keep them together, so he dropped Brian Lewis and went to Adam Johnson. But they do have a win together that's important, and so they've been in total, if you look at that, a final in Milwaukee and also a final in San Diego. So three championship matches this team of Brian Lewis and Randy Stolklos has played in before today. This will be the fourth. The challenge, however, the best team in the world.
I remember when I was a kid, waiting for the court at the beach. We'd wait for hours, then play for about 2 minutes before the big guys came and kicked us off. This was every day. Now each time I play, I hear the voice of every guy who ever told me to run home to mom. But I'm not bitter.
For joining us, and it's time for our championship match here in Grand Haven City Beach for the $135,000 Miller Lite AVP Open. This is for the Midwest Championships, $27,000 to the winner. And now, to meet the players in our Copper Tone Sport player introductions, let's send it down to Jim Errico. Jim?
Thank you very much, Paul Sunderland and Timmy Allman up in the booth. How we doing, Grand Haven? Talk to me. We are ready for our finals. Let's meet the contestants. Defending Grand Haven Open champion, say hello to Impacto, Brian Lewis. Brian's partner, future Pro Beach Volleyball Hall of Famer, three-time AVP MVP, Randy Stolklos! The number one seeds, winner of 9 events already this year on tour, out of Rio de Janeiro, Copacabana Beach, Brazil, the 1997 King of the Beach, Hard Rock Cafes, Jose Loiola!
time together since 1993. Brian Lewis and Randy Stolklos won once together, as we showed you just moments ago, taking on Kent Steffes and Jose Loiola. Steffes and Loiola have won 9 of the 12 tournaments that they have participated in. A loser in the finals at Hermosa to Canyon Seaman and Dane Blanton, and then also not a winner in Dallas and Fort Myers. There's Brian Lewis, certainly a tour veteran now, 29 years of age. Great hands, great jump serve. Maybe defense is the key, however. And Randy Stoklos just crushed the net as he went up to set that ball. Very, very nice dig by Brian Lewis, but too tight to the net.
Might have to add, they have to make the transitions. They dig balls, they got to put those balls away.
There's Kent Steffes, Olympic gold medalist last year with Karchkirai. Closing in on becoming the all-time leading money winner. If he wins a couple of more majors, he's going to be right there. He now has $2.3 million. Karch is on top all-time at a little over 2.6. There's Randy Stolklos, certainly among the greats, as you said, or as we heard Jim Rico said, will be in the Beach Volleyball Hall of Fame. You can bet on that.
Oh, yeah. He is one of the pioneers, along with a few of us. He's been around a long time, as he said, 21 years.
Stolklos, 122 career wins during that time. Number 3 all-time, Jose Loiola, 100 behind, but moving up quickly.
Taking the bull by the horns, if you might say.
No score, our final just getting started. 8 minutes at the start of this game on our Swatch game timer, the official timer of the Miller Lite AVP Tour.
Crowd is for the chanting a little Louie.
You got to think that Lewis and Stolklos have got to get off to a good start. Here a chance right away. Stolklos stuffed by Jose Loiola, so 0-for-2 right now in terms of point scoring opportunities and conversions.
Nice defense, touch block, that's what we talked about earlier. Turns on it, Jose's right there. Get out of my kitchen. Whew, he really gets over the net.
Steffes with the jump serve.
Little too close right there.
Bad set by Randy Stolklos. Jose Loiola loves to play on a natural beach because he has the best natural ability. What kind of surface is this relative to other places we've been?
This is a nice beach. It's it's a lakefront, but it's got good depth in it. It's a lot like Manhattan. So everybody's going to be jumping, but Jose is going to be jumping just a little bit more than everybody else.
And so maybe that gives even more of an advantage to Jose Loiola. And let's not forget that Kent Steffes has got some hops as well.
Oh, yeah.
Going to Brian Lewis continually. Brian Lewis, about 6'1".
He brings the heat. He's got a good arm swing, really watches the block.
I think he talked about it with Canyon Seaman courtside after their semifinal win. If he passes the ball perfectly with the way Stolklos can set the ball, he can side out against this team. That ball served just a little bit long. Will Stolklos and Lewis take even more chances, even more liberties serving the ball against a team like Steffes and Loiola?
You have to. You have to put them in trouble. If they pass the ball and get a good approach, you're not going to touch the ball.
Right.
So you've got to whip that ball, just like Jose did right there, put them in a little bit of trouble. Nice use by Randy. The first pass, if they can control the pass, they're too athletic. They know this game. They get up and over the block and put the ball away.
It reminds me of the finals, which Randy Stolklos participated in with his former partner, Troy Tanner, in Cleveland. It was absolutely perfect volleyball by Kent Steffes and Jose Loiola, but it was so good, it was like watching paint dry. They passed every ball perfectly and just methodically wore down the opposition. Brian Lewis missing it way out of bounds. There are going to be a lot of missed serves in this game from both teams, but you know that Stolklos and Lewis are going to take a lot of chances. Loiola and Steffes on top in our championship match, 1-0. And Randy Stolklos, good rhythm and swing, hammers that down the sideline.
You were saying earlier that probably two of the best setters on the beach, Randy Stolklos and Brian Lewis. Great hands. That's why they have to use them in transition. If they dig the ball up, break out those hands and put it on the net.
Stolklos looking for his first win since 1994. Over the top of Brian Lewis. You don't like that matchup, do you, Jose Loiola and Brian Lewis?
I don't like it that much. I would much prefer have Randy follow the serve up. Use your strengths, because this team is too good.
Called against Randy Stolklos in the semifinal. Talking to number one ref against Kent Steffes.
Watch his right hand really penetrate, put that ball in the bottom of the net. That's a great block. And Randy taunting a little bit after that, wants to get something stirred up.
He enjoyed that, and I stand corrected. That was Kent Steffes setting the ball. That block was against Jose Loiola. Brian Lewis to serve once again.
That's the serve.
That's four.
Reverse pokey.
Wasn't that four contacts? Randy
no.
Stoklos stopped playing. I think he lost.
I think that's what he's getting yelled at right now.
I was looking at him to see what he thought. His back was
in the hands of Randy Stoklos, and then he played.
What?
He netted. He pokes like he nets.
I didn't see the net.
Brazilian English combination.
Billy, let's go.
Kent Steffes
jumps coming
on the net. Side.
There's one, two. There's two contacts. There's three.
Well, you know, they kind of call that. Sometimes when the ball's right on the net, they call that as a
simultaneous.
Right.
But I didn't think that was simultaneous at all.
Believe me, he's pushing it.
And with that said, another jump serve that is missed down the sideline by Kent Steffes. Steffes and Loiola again, nine wins this year. Phoenix Riviera Clearwater to start things out, and then a third in Fort Myers. They bounce back and win in Miami, a fifth in Dallas.
Here we go.
A win in Corpus Christi, San Antonio. Indianapolis was postponed or discontinued because of weather, and then a win in Lake Tahoe. A runner-up in Hermosa, and then wins in Chicago, Cleveland, and then a much-deserved DNP.
That sounds like a season right there, and they still got the big ones to come.
Well, they could win. I mean, you look back at Kent Steffes' history when he was playing with Karch. He won 13 in 96, 5 in 95 because of the injury. Jose Loiola the jump serve. More numbers historically on Kent Steffes in just a moment. That ball down. Steffes wins 17 in 94, 18 in 93, 18 in 92, including tying the all-time record for 13 in a row.
And plus, this season, there's been more injuries this season in any season I can remember. So this is a good time to be healthy, be young, be in your prime, and be bombing.
So it's a bad time for both of us.
I want to go back. Just missing on that jump serve. They're really going for it, though.
We've had two Grand Slam events so far this year in Hermosa, which was to be Manhattan, but you know all about that. Had to move the side of the event down to Hermosa, and we'll be back there. And then Orlando, and we've been in Hermosa and Chicago for two Grand Slam events so far. And those are the qualification tournaments for the World Championships of Beach Volleyball that will be at UCLA.
We've got two missed serves each from Randy Stoklos and Brian Lewis.
And no aces as yet.
No aces. You want to even those out.
Very slow pace to the start of this championship. Side out by Jose Loiola. And once again, you got Brian Lewis semi-thinking about blocking. The set's a little bit off, and Jose got a lot of court to hit into.
Last game, Mike Whitmarsh and Randy and Troy Tanner couldn't hit that ball. Jose's big enough and jumps high enough to really put that ball away.
That ball just out of bounds. And, you know, Brian Lewis and Randy Stoklos are going to argue, but I saw the play, and you know what it was? The linesman, that was the rope at the end of the court, is buried, and he stepped on it and made the rope move. The ball was out. But I could see certainly where Brian Lewis and Randy Stoklos would have an argument. And Marvin, hold on to your seat. Marvin's out. Yeah, the ball was out. The ball was definitely out. But if we can get another look, you will see the linesman back up. The linesman backed up and stepped to get out of the way of the ball and hit the rope that anchors the end line, and that's what made it move. We'll take another look.
Goes off the top, just barely, slowly getting there. It's slow motion replay says, oh, I think it's a ticker tape parade.
Well, the rope was moving, and the replay doesn't lie.
The camera does not lie. And a great slow motion replay played by Brad Toberman. It's the longest ball I've ever seen.
2-0 now. Steffes and Loiola on top and starting to feel a little bit like Cleveland. Lewis and Stoklos trying to do an awful lot to get Steffes and Loiola out of their side-out game, and so far no ability to do that. Five missed serves, no aces.
Good, Brian.
Jose Loiola with his second stuff block. The first to save a point against Randy Stoklos. This time 4 point against Brian Lewis.
Jose in that from the standing jump.
jumping towards this guy. Watch his left hand. That's coming at a very high rate of speed back at you.
Ask you a question about Jose Loiola blocking after this side out.
That ball hit out of bounds. Jose Loiola never played indoors, never got any coaching. Are you surprised he's this good a blocker?
I think when he first came over here, he has so much raw talent, but he's worked hard at his blocking skills. He gets down to the beach. He has Jim Mingus he's working with. The last couple years, he's worked with Adam Johnson, who knows the game. I mean, he's come a long way in a short period of time.
Because he technically blocks very, very well, gets way over the net. Intimidating blocker. And Kent Steffes, you know, Steffes and Loiola are going to miss a lot of serves. They're siding out, and they're scoring. They're up 4-0. Why not just keep going, playing the same way, on top 4-0?
That's their game plan. The longer they sat out, they know they can wear you down between their blocking abilities. That's points.
Boy, another missed serve.
Yeah.
Well, Canyon Seaman had it pegged. He said that, maybe save for the one challenge that Kirai and Johnson offered, Steffes and Loiola have just been sort of marching through, scoring points in streaks, and siding out exceptionally well.
Like a doctor's visit. The mechanics.
Boy, this is getting ugly. How many missed serves now so far in this match? And I know all the teams are going for it. We've got 11, make that an even dozen.
Baker's dozen.
And we're not even to the first side change yet.
As the crowd reacts to the serve going in.
Nice side out by Kent Steffes.
I still like my idea of this. After seven missed serves, you have to get the serve in or it's a point for the other team.
Huh. After seven and on your own?
Yeah.
So
as a combined team.
So we'd be getting right there, right now.
Right.
Stoklos and Lewis just served their seventh ball in the court.
Come on!
Stewed over a little bit. Nice side out by Randy.
Wind dying down just a little bit, and as Canyon Seaman reported, although it's blowing where we are broadcasting from, about probably 50, 60 feet above center court, and if you look at the flags on top of the stadium, blowing very, very hard, but calm down below.
High in the Fox Nest. Nice breeze. You can see the flags trickling back and forth. And Jose's on the good side right now.
Had a great final here last year. Brian Lewis and a healthy Scott Akintubby against Adam Johnson and Jose Loiola. And Lou had a weird day. Six stuck blocks in a match. Brian Lewis only 6'1". He probably needs to repeat that today to have a chance against the number one team, Kent Steffes and Jose Loiola.
He posed down so many times, I thought he was going to cramp after he had that many blocks. You see that? He even posed up here for us.
Well, he knew that was his day.
Oh, yeah.
There's an ace.
That's how you're going to get back in it. The question is, can they possibly side out long enough and mix in a few aces to make this a beach? $27,000 to the winner, $15,000. And dinner for you and I to the loser.
Yes.
And Brian Lewis and Randy Stoklos trailing 4-1 at the side change. That was a chance. Stoklos continues to dig balls, but they've had the block by Jose Loiola, and then that could be 4-3.
That's right. You know, they start pretty slow against Whitmarsh and Troy Tanner, too. They're down 5-1, let's not forget, so... Maybe it takes a little time to get the oil moving in the motor, get it going.
That script plays out, but I think at this stage, at this tournament, having gone undefeated through the winner's bracket, Steffes and Loiola are much more well-rested than were Mike Whitmarsh and Kent Steffes. Whitmarsh and Troy Tanner together for the first time this week lost in the quarterfinals, had to play a number of extra matches, and were really out of gas at the end of that game.
It's 85
Jose
degrees
Loiola,
out here.
Yeah, Jose Loiola and Kent Steffes are not going to run out of gas.
No, that tank is full.
546!
They gave him a good battle.
No, they played well.
Little time to fix the clock on the court. Something's gone awry. Randy Stoklos doesn't like it.
A little time is a relative term. That took them a little while to get that straightened away. What they did was just take a minute off. Look at that. Coming off what didn't look like a particularly tough jump serve, not from where I'm standing anyway. Kent Steffes with the ace off Brian Lewis makes it 5-1.
Kent Steffes coming across court here. Not that hard to serve, I don't think, as you can see. Watch the inside left shoulder. Brian was there. He just missed it.
going right back to Brian Lewis.
Come on.
Read that like a book.
Come on. Oh, that's a good shot. Stoklos again playing super defense.
Okay.
A 36-year-old Randy Stoklos playing like a kid. Big save by Stoklos.
Nice shot by Ken Steffes. Randy's all over it. Nice set by Louis. Watch this spike put you straight down. Saves the point.
Randy, three times most valuable player on the Miller Lite AVP Tour in 88, 89, and 91. Karch Kirai has won that award five times. And yet another missed serve. Last time we checked, Randy Stoklos and Brian Lewis have now missed eight.
That's affirmative. Randy has five, Brian has three. And Jose calling for a little hand here. I like the way he plays to the crowd. Gets him back involved.
Line shot. Pretty good set to Jose Loiola, and he bombs that down the line. It just seems like it's a matter of time. Steffes and Loiola jump serve, they play defense, they're in shape, and they're very, very good offensively.
And they're mentally tough. I mean, yesterday they're down 14-11. They really hung in there against Karch and Adam. I mean, they're tough when the tough gets going.
Timeout taken by Randy Stoklos and Brian Lewis. Kent Steffes and Jose Loiola.
By Swatch Watches, Swiss-made timing pieces, timing only the sports that matter. And by the Hard Rock Cafe, where the AVP rocks. Paul Sunderland with Tim Hovland. Next week we will be in Milwaukee, but this week we are in Grand Haven. Certainly one of the sights that the players enjoy most. Marvelous crowds. The weather through the years. I know that sometimes in the Midwest we get thunderstorms or whatever, but the weather here has been, for the most part, to the liking of everyone, the fans and the players. Jose Loiola continues to serve. They are in control. 6-1. Now will the hubby wife make it 7-1, and this looks more and more like the finals in Cleveland, Tim.
They've got to talk about that. Jose Loiola going right up the middle here. You got it. I don't want it. Easy point. Somebody's got to call it. That's Brian Lewis's ball. When they're serving from the right side has to take that ball and call it off.
Another high, tough pass to Randy Stoklos. Pretty good looking set.
And Steffes hit it out of bounds. That's a big break. A big break for Brian Lewis and Randy Stoklos.
Louis playing a little bit of mind games with Jose.
Well, he's, you know, Jose does like to play to the crowd, but Brian Lewis probably a little frustrated more with what's happening on the scoreboard than with what Kent Steffes and Jose Loiola are doing with respect to sort of rubbing it in when they're in a big lead.
There's only one way to remedy that.
Yep.
Dial up some aces. Goes for the knuckleball.
And there, not an ace, but it forced a bad pass. And after Brian Lewis's performance here last year, he is certainly very, very popular. He put on a show last year, blocking the ball, had a marvelous time as he and Scott Akitevi went on to win over Adam Johnson and Jose Loiola. Changing things up. Little scroogey up the middle. Jose Loiola controls that. Pings it into the audience for a side out.
Louis has an array of serves he uses. The knuckleball you saw before that was a little scroogey. Sometimes it comes with a breaking curveball that really drops off the plate. Try and diagram them when he uses them again.
It's almost like, since it is baseball season, Steffes and Loiola are the best hitters in the game. They are Tony Gwynn and Larry Walker. So if you're pitching to them, you just have to hit the corners, change speeds, change look, do so many different things. Because if you give them the same look every time, they're just going to hit you out of the ballpark. It's going to be a rout. They need to be like Greg Maddux.
That's right.
Every time back to the service line. Stokey going with the floater, but it doesn't look like he goes with the floater and does not come up to the net and block.
Yeah, Ryan!
But he can play some D.
Bad set again in transition.
That's three or four opportunities. is you have got to play perfect volleyball. And Brian Lewis is a good setter with his hands and bump setting from off the court. That's a big mistake.
Even take half of those. They'd be down 7-4. You're in the game. At 7-2, you're on the brink of disaster.
Yeah, you've lost contact at this point in time, and they're not serving particularly well either.
You've been watching that movie, Contact. Is that what you come
to? No, I won't see that. I promise I wouldn't see that until my wife and kids got back from Europe. So.
All right.
My wife said, go see all the crummy ones, and we'll see Contact when you get back.
What are the crummy ones? Might as well tell us.
Well, I know I'm not going to see Batman and Robin again.
I know. I got hammered there myself.
Yep. Nice serve.
And nobody.
Steffes with the paintbrush well outside the antenna. They're scrambling just a little bit, but still managing to side out.
Right now, Louie and Stokey are not playing together as a team. They're playing individually. They have to start talking it up a little bit. That's right down the middle. Louie's either got to move over and take that. It's common for a team that has never played together before, but they have played together before.
Is it partly because they don't believe they can win?
It might be. They look like they're playing afraid. They got to loosen it up. Steph is on that. Can't bring it up.
Jose Loiola chasing that ball down. He never really had a legitimate shot at it because he got a late break.
It is difficult to put the ball away against this team because they both block, they both jump, and they can both chase and play defense.
There it is. Goes into the corner. Nice left hand. You see, for your young volleyball players out there, you got to use that left hand when going left. Nice try, just can't get it up. Jose goes for it. Kind of a weak effort, but gives it a great try. Some guys try to bring that with their right hand. That's completely wrong. Go with your left hand on your left side and right hand on your right side. Oh, Louie, there he goes.
And with the pose down, just a mini pose down, Brian Lewis knows that he's got to loosen things up, get the crowd involved, as well as his teammate Randy Stoklos trying to make a move down by four.
A good sweat isn't so good once the game is over.
Great game, Brendan.
Thanks, mate.
That's why there's Irish Spring Sport. It works hard because you play hard. Irish Spring Sport has an extra antibacterial ingredient that kills odor-causing germs better than regular soap. So I feel clean and fresh. It's Irish Spring Sport. Kills odor-causing germs, so play as hard as you like.
You're losing her, I need some blood.
Good luck.
Don't worry.
Steffes and Loiola have led from the beginning. 4-0, 4-1 side change, and now this most recent side change at 7-3. And the key for Stolklos and Lewis is to match side out for side out against Steffes and Loiola. And the question, though, Tim, is can they do that for a long period of time?
Well, right now they're not doing it. Obviously, they're down 7-3. But I think even bigger than that, they've got to put some pressure on the serve to score some points, because right now they're down by 4 points. Maybe take a little something off the serve. Make them side out a little bit. Then get your rhythm with your jump serve. Move into it. Don't try and come out going 60. Go 40 and then move it up the scale.
Midway through the last side change, they had 7 service errors. That's out of bounds. The pokey by Randy Stolklos just long.
But I like that theory right there. Stokey coming to the net, putting the pressure on the net. Another opportunity missed, but he had a good soft block.
It sort of feels to me, and I want to know what you think, Tim, that this is the match right here. If Steffes and Loiola, now on the good side, can extend this lead, you know, out to say 11-4, this is done. They will close the deal. This is where Brian Lewis and Randy Stolklos have got to get back in.
He's got the crowd behind him right now. It's time for dial him in. At least put the pressure on him.
That ball hit out of bounds. Pretty good move blocking by Randy Stolklos. No touch, and it's 7-4.
Things like that can happen.
Make him
side out.
3 straight points for Lewis and Stolklos. Excuse me, Tim.
That's my fault.
Ooh, that ball served just out of bounds. And John Martin, the umpire, is signaling that the ball is in.
Wow.
That would be a big overrule.
So the ball does go over to Kent Steffes and Jose Loiola.
No damage done. That play's forgotten. What would Stolklos and Lewis be talking about right here? They're obviously going to have to change something up.
I think Stokey's going to say, I think I'm going to go to the net a little bit. Try and take over the net, change it up. At least I hope that's what he's saying. Let Louis concentrate on the jump serve. Keep his serve in.
And Stolklos is in very, very good shape.
Mm-hmm.
He is not fatigued at all whatsoever and staying down, and they will do exactly that. Lewis drops off, Randy Stolklos to the net to block. Nice touch block.
Ball on the net, put it away.
Exactly when they needed to, Brian Lewis and Randy Stolklos getting back in, and it's been the blocking of Randy Stolklos.
Exactly, that's what he does best. Louis puts him on the net, kabang, 5-7, we're back in the game.
And nice cuff down the sideline by Kent Steffes, but making Steffes move and making him do something, change his line of attack
right.
In order to put the ball away.
Make him adjust and adapt. That's the hardest thing to do. Any good Marine will tell you that. Hey, shoot set.
Yeah, lucky play by Randy Stolklos, and not a good set. Not many players on tour will take a pass that far off the net, that high, and set it with their hand. Brian Lewis will, Scott Akitubi will, Randy Stolklos will, and that one jetted right towards the net, and Stokey was able to get the side out.
With spin to add.
Brian Lewis never played college volleyball. He was an outstanding player in junior college and then came straight out on tour. And, you know, right away you saw with the impact of his jump serve when he was just in his early 20s that he was going to have a good career out on the beach. Played some with Mike Whitmarsh, and that ball turned down the line and he was side on Jose Loiola.
First time we saw Brian Lewis was in Phoenix under St. John Smith, and we're watching this guy jump serve. I'm going, he's hitting that ball too hard. He's hitting the ball out of bounds, and all of a sudden it's hitting the back line. It's bouncing off people. About four or five tournaments in, he was really making some great adjustments.
That's a nice play offensively by Brian Lewis. Brian Lewis had a very unfortunate accident at the end of last year. He was in his pool at his house, and the light was out, and was doing the butterfly, and the pool was one stroke shorter, and hit it very violently with his mouth and knocked out several teeth. He played the last several weeks of the tour in a very, very uncomfortable fashion. A twice coach, great up by Brian Lewis.
Cut.
And good shot by Kent Steffes, demanding the cut shot from Jose Loiola from side out.
They're touching balls, they're getting them up. That's a nice play. Redirecting the shot. Stokia with another soft block. Nice touch. Louis stretching it out.
Is this what you mean by pressure?
Yes,
I mean,
Steffes
and Loiola are not siding out with ease.
They've got to calm it down. He's going deep in the corner, short in the corners. And they've scored the last 4 points in a row since adjusting. There's a timeout by Randy Stolklos.
Sand timeout taken by Randy Stolklos. We'll take a break. Steffes and Loiola talking things over along with Coach Jim Mingus. They've given up four straight.
Swimsuit model Rebecca Romaine, and this is where I live.
In Grand Haven on City Beach, $135,000 prize money for the field, $27,000 to the winner of this match between Loiola Steffes and Lewis Stolklos. That's tight. Right out of the timeout. Right out of the timeout, Randy Stolklos misses a pass, and now once again the lead for Steffes and Loiola is back to 3 at 8-5.
That's three easy points after timeouts. It came out, got aced on this side. That's as good as an ace.
Well, Brian Lewis said it to Canyon Seaman. He said, we've got to stop hitting the ball out of bounds. We've got to stop giving them points, and that was a big gift.
Score is 8-5.
Yeah, Brian Lewis and Stolklos are making sure the score is corrected here and maybe just buying some time. They're not worrying about the fact that the opposition is farther ahead than they think. The main scoreboard behind Jose Loiola has the score correctly, but up above Stadium Court, it is incorrect. It's 7-5. The score is 8-5. Loiola and Steffes in the lead. Undefeated in the lead and looking to make it. That ball inside the sideline. Remember, Steffes and Loiola have won 9 of the 12 tournaments that they have participated in, trying to make it 10 out of 13. A score is key. This is a 3-point advantage for Steffes and Loiola this year. Unlike in years past, you have to win by 2. So not only is the differential important, but the time starting to be just under 3 minutes and 20 seconds left on our swatch game clock.
Good opportunity. Nice set by Jose.
Got a score here. That set was low.
Nice cross court. Watts is over on one. Louis does his best Guns N' Roses imitation. Get down, Lou.
Brian Lewis had to do something because the transition set he gave to his partner, Randy Stolklos, was basically ugly and unhittable. Oh, ball is served just out of bounds. Brian Lewis, I think, missed that just a little bit. It's hard to tell when he misses it because he does have the screw ball, the knuckle, the half knuckle. But that one, I think, obviously missed the court, but I think he did not execute it.
The half knuckle.
It was like Randy Johnson going to Larry Walker. Just a little bit high energy. Give up another. That's big.
Huge.
We talked about through the side change, Lewis and Stolklos had to maintain contact. They were as close as two, and now they trail by 3, 9-6.
I'm going to show you a series of images, and you tell me what you see.
I see Ken Griffey Jr. hitting my fastball into the right field seats.
And this?
Griffey ripping my curve for a double.
And what about this?
Griffey.
You just can't keep me out of your head, can you?
The 97 Mariners. You gotta love these guys.
Fox Sports Northwest shines its brightest when it highlights special events that bring you closer to home teams with Fox Attitude. Whether you're looking for championship form, playoff excitement, tournament action, all-star performances, or events too unique to be part of a series, look to Fox Sports Northwest. Right alongside some of the best cyclers in the country as the final race of the National Fresca Invitational Tour winds its way through the streets of Seattle, Saturday at 3 Pacific.
I don't need much. A little food. Not that little. Whoa! A little water. Some exercise. Some attention.
Nice doggy.
Places to see. Places to go. But most of all, a place to call home.
Hi, I'm Steve Broussard of the Seattle Seahawks, reminding you to put your children first and pay your child support. Child support pays for food, clothing, and medicine. When child support payments stop, it's your kids that lose. If you owe child support, be a hero, score a touchdown for your kids, and pay the full amount on time, because children come first.
For more information, call 1-800-442-KIDS.
Home teams, Fox Attitude. You're watching Fox Sports Northwest.
The Miller Lite AVP Midwest Championships is brought to you by Honda. Experience the thrill of the all-new Prelude and the new four-wheel drive CRV. And by Irish Spring Sport. It kills odor-causing germs, so play as hard as you like. Back to championship court here in Grand Haven for the Miller Lite AVP Midwest Championships. Lots to do here as the sun starts to go down, and it'll stay light here probably until about 9 o'clock. The beach is still absolutely packed. Lots of volleyball going on the recreational courts set up here on City Beach. But here for the championship, it's Kent Steffes and Jose Loiola up 9-6 after the ace. Lewis and Stolklos have certainly had their chances. That ball hit out of bounds. Giving up two in a row. Brian Lewis said it. You can't hit the ball out of bounds. You can't give them freebies. And Lewis and Stolklos do exactly that back-to-back. 10-6.
The intimidation of Loyola's block made that ball go out. Loyola has three blocks in this match. And straight down blocks, I might add.
Keeping it on Brian Lewis. Pretty good pass. Don't see too many back sets out on the beach because you're always, you know, there's just two players out here, but there are a few players who have the unique ability to dish the ball with accuracy and cleanly over their heads, and Stolklos is one of them.
Watch his hands up above his head, contacts the ball very nicely, perfect set. And Louis delivers the words.
And did you see how solid his feet were? Sprinted all the way to the ball, but when he touched the ball, his feet were set and solid. Stolklos not coming in. And he was right there, right there, and is still right there, but could not dig that ball off the bat of Jose Loiola.
On this side, I would go to the jump serve a little bit more.
Well, they're on the good side. The
exactly.
Wind blowing in their faces. Canyon Seaman telling us during the side change that it was very, very hot, not that much wind down below, but that's the only way Stolklos and Lewis are going to get back in. That ball over the top and down. Loiola reading cross court. 10-6, Jose Loiola and Kent Steffes in the lead, but they have not always been in control. It was 7-5, 8-6. Lewis and Stolklos looking for the 8-7 side change and then gave up an ace, and then Brian Lewis hit a ball out of bounds, and right back in control are Steffes and Loiola.
No easy ones, and they're giving them away in bunches. There's one. It's creeping back in, 7-10. You've got to make your serves to score points. The key to Mike Dodd, Mike Whitmarsh, they're always putting the pressure on you. You know, the jump serve is great, but if it's not happening, take a little something off, make them side out, change your game.
Well, you have to have confidence and an ability to score in other areas, which Dodd and Whitmarsh have, digging the ball and also blocking. Steffes and Loiola have opened the door a little bit here. They are, you know, I guess if you use the Tiger Woods vernacular, they are not playing their A game right now, maybe their B game. And given Lewis and Stolklos some chances. Nice hit by Randy Stolklos, strong. And Kent Steffes given the
stink eye to Marvin Hall. That ball moving a little bit off the set of Brian Lewis.
Marvin is a pretty lenient referee. You have to know how far you can push it. Marvin's pretty open about the setting, usually. I mean, if he has a bad day, you never know.
Well, what the players want is consistency.
Exactly.
They want one, if we're going to call one at 1-0, they want the same called all the way through.
It's all we ever ask for.
No, you want a favoritism.
Because I can't set.
Side out by Steffes and Loiola, and now they're starting, I think, to just concentrate on their side out mm-hmm. game and keep Stolklos and Lewis at bay with 2 minutes and 14.9 seconds left. Good shot. Good adjustment. Again, not a particularly accurate set from Ryan Lewis.
He can get that with his hands if he wants to.
Yeah.
Louis back to serve. Made 6 service errors so far with 1 ace. Not a good ratio.
Nope.
That's a good serve.
Cut.
Nice block by Randy Stoklos. Stoklos, one of the best blockers along with yourself, among others, in the late 80s and early 90s. But this is a good adjustment and good move.
Very nice. Watch him move his feet a little bit. I don't know if you saw that on the replay. He moved his feet to the spot where the ball was, penetrated, put the ball back down. 8-10.
Very patient. Did not overjump that time. Tough serve from Brian Lewis again. And nice turn down the sideline by Jose Loiola. And I think the right move to drop off by Lewis and Stoklos. Just too good a shot.
If he can make that shot, you give it to him. If not, you've got that ball up. You're swinging for a point. They're sneaking back into this game quietly. They're 8-10. They've had some opportunities.
Well, they had similar opportunities at 7-5 and 8-6. They need the 10-10 side change, and then this will get very interesting. Look at that. That's just an absolute freebie. And Randy Stoklos looking over to Brian Lewis and saying, help me. And Brian saying, I can't help you. You set the ball over the net.
Watch Kent straight down. And then Stokey says a little something. But Kent says, nice set, Jose. 50-50. Timeout. They're having a little bit of problem out here with Louis and Stokey right now.
Got to sort things out right now. Once again, Stoklos and Lewis within two, but just like that, it is 3.
Home teams, Fox Attitude. You're watching Fox Sports Northwest. Fort Southwest Sporting Events. One lucky winner and a guest will have their choice of one trip per month for 12 consecutive months. We get you the tickets. Southwest Airlines provides the airfare. So enter the Year of Sports sweepstakes today. Brought to you by Fox Sports Southwest and Southwest Airlines. With fares so low, you have the freedom to fly. Fox Sports Northwest is pleased to announce this week's winner of the Boeing Youth Baseball Player of the Week Award, Kyle McKinney. Kyle is 12 years old and plays for the South Highline Cubs. He's a straight-A student and has 21 RBIs and 5 home runs this season. Kyle gets a special trophy and tickets to a Mariners game, as well as this on-air salute from Fox Sports Northwest. Send your Boeing Youth Baseball Player of the Week Award nominations to the Boeing Youth Baseball Award, care of Fox Sports Northwest, 3626 156th Avenue Southeast, Bellevue, Washington, 98006. August 19 is day one, when FX premieres The X-Files. 5 nights a week, the original cuts starting with episode 1. But you may never see it, because your cable company may not carry FX. To get FX, call 1-800-FX-FX-FX1. We'll get your cable company on the line, so you can get The X-Files on FX. Fox on cable. Call for the best primetime on cable. Your cable company needs to hear from you, now.
When the smoke clears, see who's standing. Fight Night at the Forum, the ultimate test of courage and power. Fight Night at the Forum, Monday at 8 on Fox Sports Northwest.
This is the Miller Lite AVP Midwest Championships, our championship match, and not a grand slam. We've already gotten a couple of those in the bag in Hermosa and Chicago, and those are points that will get you to the Players' Championship. These are points that will get you to the World Championships of Beach Volleyball. You see Steffes, Loiola, Blanton, Seaman, Tanner, Stoklos. That's the top group of 8 that will qualify should it stay like this. You see the dollar amounts.
Those represent only the money they've won at the two Grand Slams. $43,000 for Jose Loiola, Kent Steffes, but Jose Loiola's won $219,000 this year. Kent Steffes has already won $171,000. The discrepancy coming from the money that Jose Loiola won at King of the Beach in Las Vegas. He is the ninth King of the Beach. And Randy Stolklos, another unforced error. That's been the difference. Just like that, it's 12-8, and we will take the side change. Brian Lewis and Randy Stolklos tried to sort things out during that most recent timeout. They'll have even more time now, down four.
His name is Nanook. In the Canadian Arctic, he's worshipped and feared. And this year, we're having a party in his backyard. The Molson Ice Polar Beach Party with Collective Soul in the polar bear capital of the world. Look for specially marked cases of Molson Ice, Golden, and Canadian. Nanook awaits.
You know, it's Arnold Palmer is going to come, which we might as well not invite anyone else. If he and I come and play, it'll be good enough for me.
Well, he won't need anybody else if he brings Arnie, because you know, the crowd will come out and just follow him. Anytime you get this group of pros coming into your hometown where you don't normally get them, you need to come out and watch them play.
The Fred Couples Invitational, July 28th and 29th. Tickets available in customer service at all Nordstrom stores in Washington, except Vancouver.
Arena football is in your face on Fox Sports Northwest as the Portland Forest Dragons smoke out the opposition. You get twice the game in half the space as these bad boys bull their way between the walls and the hard places. It's bone-crushing, it's brain-bruising, it's fast, it's furious, and sometimes it's in your lap. Arena football. Big guys, big plays, big game. Up close and personal on Fox Sports Northwest. Home teams, Fox attitude. The Forest Dragons go after the Predators in Orlando, Friday night at 7.
You're watching Fox Sports Northwest.
Welcome back to Grand Haven City Beach, and while we have a moment, look at our BMW Ultimate Player Statistical Leaders. It's a combination of blocks and aces on top. Jose Loiola, Mike Whitmarsh, Brian Lewis, Dane Blanton, Kent Steffes, Troy Tanner. A couple of statistical things to point out. Jose Loiola with 160 aces, Brian Lewis with 166. Mike Whitmarsh is leading things in blocks with 153. At the end of the season, the player with the highest cumulative result, right now it's Jose Loiola, will get a most beautiful most motorcycle beautiful. From BMW.
Yeah, no one. Come on!
Off the top of the tape, looking for 13. Steffes cross court. Reverse upside down.
Not called
not together gator.
A gator. You've got to gator that with your underhand. Kind of slipped through the gator's jaws there for another easy point, 13-8.
13-8. We should look back at the year's results. Kent Steffes and Jose Loiola won three out of the first four. Then they were losers in Fort Myers, finished third. Randy Stolklos going on. But they have won 9 out of 12, and if you go back to their overall winning percentage coming into this weekend, their record now is 72-5. They were 67-5 coming in. Five more match victories after this. They will be 73-5, and their winning percentage will be up over 95%.
The few, the proud, the five, the rich.
The rich meaning Jose Loiola and Kent Steffes. Exactly. You got to count yourself. You know, we're still counting ourselves on one hand the number of matches they have lost over halfway through the season.
Well, I think this will be the second tournament if Stolklos and Lewis don't get to double figures, that they've held every opponent under 10 points.
Yeah, there was one team, and that, of course, being Karchkarai and Adam Johnson, that pushed them.
Thank you for
that was the only one. That was the only one. Other than that, they've been in complete control against the best players in the world.
Yes.
And this is a team, Jose Loiola and Kent Steffes, that are going to be together for a long, long time. And you look at the numbers, Kent Steffes, with a win here today, will go to career win number 99. We'll be looking for his 100th next week in Milwaukee.
Nobody.
Nice play up the middle by Kent Steffes, and figure that they could. When Kent was playing with Karch, he was averaging about 15 wins a year.
Yeah.
And let's just assume that number. Jose Loyola and Kent Steffes could have 5 or 6 good years together. That's 75 to 90 more wins. Kent Steffes could push 200 if he stays healthy for a career. And if he stays around that long. Yeah. Well, he's only 28 years of age. Jose Loyola, 27. So we're only talking about 33 years of age. Randy Stoklos is now 36.
Ton of time left on that squad.
Yeah, so
I thought when they got together, they get 15 wins this year. That's right. What I put it at. And I think they're right on pace for that or more.
And they took one off. Nice touch by Brian Lewis.
Oh. Randy's got to talk that up.
Nice play.
They're not playing together as a team. And Randy's got to talk. Louis's got to talk. You stay together. You win as a team, you lose as a team.
Well, we know Mike Dodd's going to be back next week.
Right.
Will he be back with Mike Whitmarsh?
That's a yes.
Okay, so where does Troy Tanner go?
As I've stated before, I'm going to say, Hyger, this is all hypothetical things here, but I would say...
Hypothetical?
Hypothetical. I'm going to go with it. I'm going to say Hyger, and then it'll blow down from there.
And then Brian Lewis and Randy Stoklos stay together.
Yes.
Okay. They've proven that they can be competitive.
I don't know. They're not having a good time out there right now. They are not enjoying themselves thoroughly. And they're in this game 13-8, but I don't feel the enthusiasm.
And they should have had it, in my opinion, being within 2 points,
yeah.
Not once, not twice, but 3 times of the number one team on the beach. 3 times they were within two. Another missed serve. Look at those totals right now. Brian Lewis.
Oh, he's up about...
Including that miss right there.
Seven.
Seven with one ace, and Randy Stoklos 6 with no aces. So the misses are not necessarily the issue, but the misses without any aces to balance things out. That's an issue.
That's a throw call on Randy Stoklos. He won't even argue that.
Third throw of Championship Sunday. We had 2 in the semifinal. And that's number 3. Brian Lewis rubbing his arms with some sand. Maybe that ball a little bit wet. Our first championship point. Kent Steffes and Jose Loyola looking for their 10th win on the year.
Oh, that was close right there, too. But on point game.
Yeah, I like the
call. Don't call it. And don't argue it. Jose and Ken should not even bring that up.
I like the no call.
Yeah, I like the no call, too.
Brian Lewis mimicking a little bit right now that, you know, his point being as he's running around the court is that Steffes and Loyola don't even try to set the ball with their hands. At least give us some credit. We try to set the ball overhand.
They don't care where credit is. If the ball, you set the ball with your bum set. I don't want to play with somebody who can't hit a bad set. You know, if you can't hit
you can't play with anybody that can't hit a bad set.
If you can't hit the ball from 3 feet off, we don't want to play with you.
Championship point number 2, Steffes and Loyola. Not all was in control, but at the times they needed to make a big play, they either did or got a lot of cooperation.
Exactly.
44.8 seconds left, and Steffes is pointing at the scoreboard. Brian Lewis, again, talking about the bump-setting strategy and implementation of Kent Steffes and Jose Loyola, and Steffes said, Brian, scoreboard.
There's some bad blood going on out there. It's a little late. I'd have started that about 10-8. Louis revving it up.
Louis shooting in and misses just wide.
The players know this game is sacked, bagged, and put away. So they're out there trying to get a little fire for next week or put something in the old skillet to get them going.
A little bit like the end of a hockey game that's a blowout. There's always a chippy little play or a fight or something like that. Championship point number 3. Steffes and Loyola looking for win number 10 on the year. That ball hit by Randy Stoklos
off the block of Jose Loyola.
He's been beat now. How many times in the finals?
Well, this is
sixth time.
Sixth final. Sixth final this year.
It does not sit well.
Yeah, but we should point out, Randy Stoklos has had a much better year than I anticipated. Better year than you anticipated.
That's for sure.
6 finals so far. It just is a matter of fact right now that Steffes and Loyola are a whole notch ahead of the rest of the field. That ball hammered cross court. Championship point number 4, 27.3 seconds left on our Swatch game clock. Steffes and Loyola playing to the crowd a little bit and want it.
They want it. They want it over with.
Jose.
His name is Nanook. In the Canadian Arctic, he's worshipped and feared. And this year, we're having a party in his backyard. The Molson Ice
twice golden and Canadian, Nanooka wins.
Lewis and Stolklos are going to finish in second position this week here against Steffes and Loiola. And as we showed you earlier, when Brian Lewis and Randy Stolklos were together in 1993, they made it into three finals, so this is their fourth together. Quick set.
Set, mixing it up a little bit, which I think they should do. They've got great hands. If they're not side and out, sometimes go for a reverse or not like that. It's like a shoot set out to the antenna. Well, Jose's going to be a little bit late, use the ball out of bounds, and that'd be especially great for Brian Lewis to use.
Well, saw an awful lot of that at the Olympic Games.
Right.
Where the interpretation of ball control and setting is 180 degrees different. And it was fun to watch.
But they can do it clean.
Yeah, Pothurst and Cook, the Australian team that won the bronze medal in the women's competition, ran a lot of plays, and it was fun to watch. Championship point, number five. Down the line and out of bounds. Jose Loiola still trying to finish things off. And this is a fait accompli, one long rally, and it's over. 10 seconds left in our championship match. Seconds left, and this will about do it. Steffes and Loiola congratulating one another. They've had a solid tournament. The only team that really challenged them, and I think Lewis and Stolklos did, they just could not close the deal, was Karch Kirai and Adam Johnson, who had them down 14. Stokey trying to, yeah, that should do it. Get it over with. That's the championship, a solid tournament once again. And win number 10 for Kent Steffes and Jose Loiola.